ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ತೆ ಟುಡೆ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಟು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ಆಸ್ ಯೂಶುವಲ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ತ್ರೀ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎಡ್ಜಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅ ಕಾರ್ನರ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲಿನೇಷನ್ ವಿತ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ಹೆಚ್ ಪಿ ಟಿಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಟ್ ರಿಮೈನ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ When it comes to the third condition, see that axis inclination will be given with respect to VP. When it is axis inclination, ensure you check for a non-beta case and a beta case problem. Coming to the question, a pentagonal prism, 25 mm sides of base and 60 mm axis length rests on HP on one of its corners of the base. So this is your first condition, such that the two of the base edges containing the corner on which it rests makes equal inclination with respect to HP. I have told you can directly neglect this sentence. This sentence will be given in case of planes as well as in solid if it is resting with the corner. Draw the projection of the prism when the axis of a prism is inclined to HP at 40 degree. This is your second condition. And when it comes to the third condition, have a look and appears to be inclined to VP at 45 degree. Since appearance sentence is given, this is a non-beta case problem, same as your planes and pyramid problems. Draw one pentagon for corner position. I have taken right side as a reference for 25 mm sides. Write this 25 mm and you can show this angle. This is 108 degree and this is a center. We have calculated by drawing perpendicular bisector. This is OO1. When it comes to naming for a corner, so AA1, BB1, CC1, DD1 and this is EE1. Next, from the all the points you project to XY line. After projecting from the center, be careful, from the center you need to raise the height for an axis height. This is O dash and this is O1 dash. Similarly, from all the points, raise the height and meet this particular. After completing this, so you show this dimension, this is 60 mm. Next, from the front view, A, B, C is clearly visible. D and E is not visible. So this will be A dash of E dash. And this is B dash of D dash. Next, this is C dash. When it comes to the base part, again A1, B1, C1 is visible. D1 and E1 is not visible. So this will be A1 dash of E1 dash. And this is B1 dash of D1 dash. And this is C1 dash. Coming to the second condition. So axis is inclined to HP at 40 degree. Same as your pyramids, take one convenient point, draw this base edge. So this is your 90 minus the given angle. So mean to say that 90 minus 40, it should be 50 degree. Next, call this point as C1 dash. Next, from this C1 dash to B1 dash, you measure and mark this. This is B1 dash of D1 dash. Again, from C1 dash, you measure O1 dash, mark this. Again, you measure A1 dash of E1 dash. After this, from all these points, draw 90 degree lines. After drawing this, measure this particular C1 dash to C dash. Since all the lengths are same, you start cutting arcs and complete this figure. After completing this, ensure you extend this axis and measure this angle. Now this will be 40 degree because you have taken this base edge as 90 minus given angle, that is 50 degree. Next, from all the points project down, and from all these points project to the right side to get a top view in the second position. After projecting, meet this point. This is O1 and this is O. Next, when it comes to the rest part, meet this point. This is A, this is B, C, D, and this is E. Next, similarly, meet this particular point. This is A1, B1, C1, D1, and E1. So after meeting all these points, you can remove this extra projection part and you can also show the direction of projections. Next, meet the boundaries point. So that is C, B, B1, A1, E1, D1, D, and C. This forms a boundary for this particular solid. After drawing this boundary part, have a look. From the top view, this top face is clearly visible, so highlight this particular pentagon. After highlighting this, again from the top view, A1 dash is clearly visible, E dash to E1 dash is clearly visible, so join this with a continuous line. Since base part is not visible, so the left out edge is this, D1 and C1. This supposed to be a dotted line. Next, from the top view, C dash to C1 dash is not visible. So this supposed to be drawn with a dotted line. And have a look, till this C1 to O1, you can show this axis line. Actually speaking, this supposed to be shown from O1 to O, but this particular area, that is C1 to O, this edge covers. So left part, you can show this one. Proceeding to the third condition, that is axis appears to be inclined at an angle 45 degree. Since appearance is given, this is a non-beta case problem. Draw one axis line for a given angle, that is 45 degree. Next, measure from C to this particular point. I will call this as say 1. That is from 1 to C you measure. So after measuring this, so this is C point and this is 1 point. For simplicity, I will name this point as 2 and this point as 3. Now, measure from 1 to O1. Mark here, call this as O1. And O1 to point 2, measure, call this as 2. And 2 to C1, mark this. Similarly, measure from C to 3, call this as 3. Next, 3 to O, so this is O. Next, from O to this particular edge, say I will call this as 0.4. So mark this. Next, from all these points, draw 90 degree. Have a look. From one point, if I draw 90 degree line, I can get A1 and E1. So measure 1 to A1 and mark this. So this is A1 and this is E1. Similarly, if I draw 90 degree line from point 2, I will get B1 and D1. So draw this 90 degree, mark this too, that is D1 and B1. So similarly, coming to this particular point 3, if you draw this line, again, this length remains same as this, that is 3 to D, you measure. So 3 to D is same as 3 to B. Again, it is same as 2 to D1 to B1. So mark this as B. Next, from this particular point, that is from point 4, draw one more 90 degree line. After drawing this, A1 length remains same here. That is 4 to A or 1 to A1 is same. So you mark this.
meet all these points, you can replace this figure here. So what we have done, we have just joined all the points and we have done a replica of this figure here. Next, from all these points project up, and from all these points project to the right side. After projecting, meet the points carefully. This is O1 dash, this is A1 dash, B1 dash. We know that the resting point always falls on XY line. This is C1 dash, this is D1 dash and E1 dash. Similarly, you meet this. This is O dash. Next, this will be your A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash and E dash. Next, you can draw the boundary lines first and you can proceed the problem. I will tell you one trick. Since from the front view, the base part is clearly visible, you first complete that particular. So you need not to get panic in case of prism. So same as your pyramid, draw this base part first. Then have a look from A1 to A. It is a continuous line because it is not dividing the base. Similarly, from B1 to B, and again from E1 dash to E. After completing this continuous line, have a look from D1 dash to D dash. It is dividing the base, it should be dotted, and again from C1 dash to C dash, it should be a dotted line. After completing all these things, have a look. You can clearly make out E dash, A dash and B dash is falling in a boundary. So you can join this with a continuous line. Next, further, this E dash, D dash, C dash, it is not visible from the front view. So you can draw this with a dotted line. Next, last, you meet O2, O1 with an axis line. This completes your problem.